Hey everyone, Zach Tucker out here at East Forsyth High School getting you ready for our Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Friday Night Rivals Game of the Week presented by My48. This week it's a Forsyth County matchup as West Forsyth plays against East Forsyth here in Kernersville. We're joined now by Eagles head coach, Coach Willard. And Coach, the Eagles are flying high, soaring right now with a 9-0 record on the season. We just had you guys on a couple weeks ago against Mount Tabor. Kind of fill me in about how stuff's happened since then.
You know, obviously we've been blessed right now. We kept on winning, but this Friday is a big game. Obviously it's for outright conference champion and, you know, a lot of implications for the playoff seating also.
The last time we talked about your quarterback, Bryce Baker, who's not only one of the best in this state, but one of the best in the country. And I want to show some love to some of the other top playmakers on your team, Jair Richburg, JP Gilchrist. Talk to me about some of those dynamic playmakers and what they bring to your offense.
Yeah, obviously those are two top receivers on our team. It's hard to, you can't double cover both of them really. It's a hard thing because we actually can throw in Jalen Murray, who's a running back, slot receiver. And then we got some great running backs in Cannon Rottweiler and Corey Blair. So, I mean, it's hard to be able to just focus on one guy. But JP and Jai just have an outstanding years right now.
Of course, we've got a big-time matchup against West Forsyth. No explanation, big-time conference matchup. And you could say that this is for the conference championship, at least outright for East Forsyth.
Correct.
Tell me a little bit about the Titans.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of skilled players. They work hard. They're really big up front. Probably one of the first teams that will be as big or maybe bigger than us on the O-line and D-line. So that'll be a great matchup. And, you know, they're well coached by Kevin Wallace over there.
Talk to me a little bit about the rivalry over the years between West and East and what makes it so special.
Yeah, it's kind of switched a little bit. Obviously, when Adrian Snow was over there, me and him had our long history of not liking each other. Now we do like each other. And Kevin and I have always kind of been friends, so it's not so crazy. But it's a good rivalry. You know, there's not ill intentions or anything. It's just a good game. You know, one side of the county versus the other. And the fans and schools enjoy it.
And as we mentioned earlier, this is the chance for East to outright win the conference championship on Friday night. And even if things don't go your way, you can still tie. But as the great Al Davis said, just win, baby, and it's all yours. How does it feel to be in this position once again where you can control your own destiny and win the conference championship and go for that three-peat?
Yeah, that's what you want. You know, you want to be able to control your own destiny. You don't have to rely on anybody or anything, and that's what we got in front of us. We got to come out, play well, do what we need to do, and hopefully end up with that top seed coming out of our conference.
Not only will the game be here at East Forsyth on Friday, but it'll be a special night. You guys will be honoring the senior class for senior night. Just kind of talk to me about what the senior class has meant to this program.
Yeah, a bunch of great leaders. We got a great senior class. The leadership out of this class is unbelievable. And it's always a special night. Get to have it on TV, senior night, so that adds a little more to it. But what a great senior class and a chance to three-peat as conference champions.
Now, one of the cool things that you guys are doing and part of this game is selling T-shirts as a fundraiser for those impacted by Helene in the western part of the state. Just kind of talk to me a little bit about that and why it's important for East Forsyth to be part of something like this.
Yeah, Alan Plaster, our AD, is kind of spearheading this. And a lot of it has to do, we have some ties up there. We have former teacher here, Alford, Glenn Alford, used to work here. He was a coach, and his wife taught at another school here. They are now teaching one at T.C. Roberson and one at A.C. Reynolds. So there's a lot of impact that kind of, you can feel it. It's personal. And we just want to make sure we keep doing our parts. A lot of the stuff came in early. We don't want it to fade off, you know, so we're just trying to do our little bit, our part to keep on helping and supporting the people up there in Northwest North Carolina.
Yeah, now you could say that this game will be on the big screen as we broadcast this all over the Piedmont Triad on My48 and on our website, YouTube channel, Facebook page. Mm-hmm. You could say, like I just mentioned, that we're going to be putting it on the big screen. So I got to ask you, Coach, what's your favorite football movie?
My favorite football movie, probably Remember the Titans.
Any particular player or actor, I should say, that stands out or any scene?
I just remember watching it all the time and so many sayings out of it, you know, left side, strong side, all that kind of stuff. I love the defensive part of it.
Yeah, that's been a pretty popular answer with some of the other coaches that we've asked that question. But with this also being Halloween this week, we've got a lot of people, you know, going out trick-or-treating. So a little bit of a curveball here, but you know, what would you say is your favorite trick play that you've ever ran or ever seen on the football field?
I love running trick plays on our punt team. If you follow East Forsyth football, we do a lot of trick plays on our punt team. So I would say I love doing that.
What's your final message to all the Eagles fans out there before kickoff on Friday?
Hey, let's have Eagle Nation out here support us. We need to have that 12th man in the stands. That's very important, having all that amped up, and to wish these seniors their best and hopefully get a three-peat.
Awesome. All right, well, thanks so much for your time today, Coach Willard. I appreciate it, and good luck on Friday and the rest of the way this season.
Thank you very much.
All right, let's go ahead and send it over to West Forsyth. All right, well, we are now out here at West Forsyth High School in Clemens, and joining us now is the head man for the Titans, Coach Wallace. And Coach, the Titans are 7-2 on the season, and we actually met up with you earlier this season, yep, against Oak Grove. Just kind of fill me in about how things have gone since then.
I think right now, last couple weeks, we're sitting 5-0 the last 5 weeks. Offensively, we've been hitting our stride. Defensively, he's played strong all year long. But offensively, I think we've gotten better every week that we have played this year, so we're just excited for this game.
Yeah, and one of the key guys for your team this year is C.J. Blevins, and mm-hmm. he averages about 100 yards a game rushing for you guys. How neat is it to have a player like that that can produce consistently week to week?
Yeah, he's been a great player for us all year, and then we've been able to mix in a little Darrell Page in the backfield with him, and both have been great for us, and I think it gives complement each other very well.
I think what's nice, too, is some football teams have some family ties, and you've got the Eldridge brothers here at West Forsyth. Tell me a little bit about the impact that those brothers have had on your team.
Yeah, so we got two of them this year. Last year we had three. We'll have three in about 2 years. There's a lot of them. But both have been great, D-Rock and Turtle. Both great players, both great leaders, both great people in the locker room. They're fun to be around, always smiling, and easy to talk to and everything.
Now we've got a big-time matchup this Friday night, no explanation, against East Forsyth. Yep. Tell me a little bit about the Eagles.
I mean, they're 9-0, number one in the conference right now, won it last year. So, I mean, they're a very good team, explosive on offense, solid on defense, a lot of tradition, a lot of history with them. So they're a great team, and we're excited for the opportunity.
Not to put the cart before the horse, but if it does turn out to be successful for West Forsyth on Friday, you guys could be looking at a potential tie for the conference championship. How would that, you know, does that kind of excite you to be in that sort of spot here this point in the season?
Yeah. Every year we start out, we have four goals, winning record, playoffs, conference championship, and state championship. So this would be exciting that we could hit the third of our fourth goals.
And talk to me a little bit about the rivalry between East and West over the years.
They've been consistently, we're in the top 2 to 3 teams in the conference every year, and it just goes back a long ways, even with Coach Snow, and just been always been a great game. It's always been a competitive game usually, and for last year and this year, it'd be up for the conference championship.
You could say that we are putting your game on the big screen all across the Piedmont Triad on My48. So I've got to ask you, Coach Wallace, what is your favorite football movie of all time?
Couple favorites, like my wife loves Remember the Titans. I'm a big old school of the program, but I think I'm going to have to go with The Replacements. I'm a comedic guy, so I kind of like The Replacements.
Yeah, any characters or scenes from that movie that stand out to you?
I like the movie. I think it's funny. I think it's comical, especially when the O-linemen have to take care of their quarterback in the parking lot and the bees on the field. There's a lot of things in there. I think it's funny.
Yeah, and of course, we've got Halloween going on this week, and a lot of people are saying trick or treat. And so I've got to ask you, Coach Wallace, what is your favorite trick play that you've either done on a football field or you've seen happen on the football field?
Anyone who's coached with me, usually we have something called hide the baby. And it's out of a trick formation and kind of sneak it to a running back, and he gets out late on it. So we ran it, had it in for last year. We didn't end up running it last year, but 2 years ago we ran it. So it's a trick play that I think all of our assistant coaches always talk about because it's funny.
Yeah. Now, what is your final message to all the Titans fans out there before kickoff on Friday?
We want everyone out there, bring a lot of noise, bring a lot of excitement. It's going to be a great atmosphere, and hopefully we can pull it out at the end.
Awesome. All right. Well, thanks so much for your time
today,
Coach
Wallace.
I appreciate it, and good luck Friday night and the rest of the season.
Thank you.
All right. Well, for more Inside the Headset content, subscribe to the ABC 45 YouTube channel.